Good morning, my name is Ian Dusza. I am from Institute of Materials Research, Slovak Academy of Sciences, Slovakia, Košice, and I prepared for you an overview on micro nanomechanical testing of advanced ceramics. This research we are doing maybe 10 years at our institute, very intensively during the last 5-6 years, mainly thanks to Tamás Csanády, who made a PhD study on this subject, but also thanks to colleagues from the institute, from Slovakia, and the research we carried out in a very wide collaboration with colleagues from Hungary, from United Kingdom, from United States, Poland, and so on and so on. So it is a very wide collaboration on this very, very interesting topic. Why nano and micro mechanical testing? This is a very interesting area of research for metallic materials started maybe 15 years ago. In ceramics a little later, thanks the MEMS devices, because of the mechanical properties of small structures cannot simply be extrapolated from the properties of bulk samples, because of the nano micro mechanical testing can help in design for materials based on their local mechanical properties, and so on, and so on. So the area is very interesting, and we are working very hard in this field. Over the world, there are very nice groups working in similar subject on micro nano indentation in the United Kingdom, Spain, in Italy, and so on, micropillar testing, micro cantilever testing, Japan, Tatami, Richard Todd, Anglada, and so on, microscratch, G. So the area is very interesting for ceramic researchers, and our group in Košice, we are working hard in this field. Why? I would like to give you some two very, very simple motivation. The first is a really simple. Probably you know that we are able to prepare different ceramics, silicon nitride, zirconium diboride, and others in the form of texture. So you see, the texture materials semantically and in reality, and if we are able to study through micro nano mechanical testing, for example, the anisotropy of the individual grains, is very important, because it's not the same what we have on the surface of the specimen or tool. If we have orientation with higher hardness, higher wear resistance, and other properties, it's very important. So it's important to study the anisotropy of individual properties in the ceramic grains through the micro nanomechanical testing. The second motivation is more connected with the basic research. We believe that to understand the deformation mechanisms in such a brittle materials as advanced ceramics help us to improve their ductility and help us to contribute in design and preparation of a new breed of hard yet ductile polycrystalline ceramics in the form of thin film layer bulk, but which can withstand extremely high temperatures and are less prone to corrosion than metals, but possess enhanced room temperature ductility and reliability. So this is a basic research, and of course the results will come not tomorrow, but we believe that there is a way to reach such a goal. So I go to show you an overview on micro and nano mechanical testing of advanced ceramics we are doing in Košice in Slovakia, and only to compare with the traditional fracture mechanics. You know, I am an old guy. I am 68. I am working very hard from the beginning of my career on the fracture mechanics of ceramics, of course at macro level. You know, we used specimens like 35 millimeter long for bending 3 points, 4 point bending test or fracture toughness test, or some ceramics testings are even with higher dimension for geoscience. They are only to compare the micro nano. They are tests with micro character, for example the indentation fracture toughness test. It is an example for glass. And they are nano tests. You see an imprint after the nano hardness test, Berkovich indenter, and some specimens between micro nano. So it's not easy to define the nano, but for example, for hardness test, we can define what is nano and what is micro and what is macro. In this way, we can say that the macro hardness is when the applied load is higher than 2 N. The micro hardness we can define when the indentation load is lower than 2 N, but the depth, the indentation depth, is larger than 200 nanometer. And we speak about the nano hardness when the indentation depth is below about 200 nanometers. So this is for hardness test. Of course, not all micro nano mechanical test is defined in such a way, but I can show according to my opinion which test belongs to micro nano mechanical test. The hardness, you see the imprint and the surrounding deformation area in the tungsten carbide grain. The second, the so-called micro pillar test. The third, the micro tensile test. You see the magnifications. So it is really micro tensile test. Here you can see a micro cantilever test, and here the scratch or tribological test. Today I will give you some very interesting examples as regards the micro nano hardness, micro pillar, and micro cantilever tests. So, which type of materials we studied? We studied different ceramics from traditional tungsten carbide, in tungsten carbide cobalt, to very new systems as ultra high temperature ceramics. Here you see zirconium diboride. Characteristic microstructure by scanning microscopy, some defects of course, and by EBSD analysis. Here you see another one, also silicon nitride, also scanning microstructure and EBSD microstructure with differently orientated grains. As you see, the grain size is high, about 20-30 micron. You know, to do micro nano mechanical test, in one grain, it is possible only when the grain size is not very low, not very, very submicron or nano grain size. We will see some other examples, but we try to select ceramics for such a test with higher grain size. The next system, you see the grain size are lower. Zircon diboride composites with silicon carbide and bor carbide. Other systems, as I mentioned, traditional tungsten carbide cobalt. It is from UK. It is a large grain size, tungsten carbide cobalt systems. The reason was, as I explained, to have large tungsten carbide grains, which allow us to perform really micro tests in such a grains. And as I told you, we study also very new systems. Tamás Csanády will speak about the really recently developed high entropy ceramics, high entropy carbides. We developed in collaboration with our friends Professor Michael Rees in Queen Mary University of London, and we are collaborating in this field also with our friends from China, but other systems we are developing in collaboration with our friends from Missouri, Professor Fahrenholz. So the collaboration is very, very wide. I would like to show you the experimental methods we are using for such a nano micro mechanical test. For example, for micro nano indentation, we are using Berkovich tip. We are using a set of indents. We are performing this usually with CSM mode, and the depth limit is from 100 to 300 nanometer. Before the test, we of course prepare the specimens and we mapping the microstructure usually by scanning and EBSD microscopy. We select the place where we would like to put the indents, as you see here, and then you see here, and we put a lot of indents during the night, and the second day we came to study the imprints, the deformation characteristics, and other things. And of course, we are using different microscopy, scanning electron microscopy, EBSD mode, atomic force microscopy, and so on. The second method I mentioned, the micropillar compression. Again, we prepare the material, polish, grinding, polishing. We are selecting areas, grains. In this case, it is a tungsten carbide grain crystal with basal orientation 001. And we prepare a micropillar using focus ion beam FIB technique. The micropillar looks like this one, with such a dimension, the radius about 1 micrometer, and the height is about 4 or 5 micrometer. So we can prepare such a micropillar from differently orientated grains in tungsten carbide cobalt system, but in any type of ceramics. And here you can see it is a prismatically orientated micropillar. When we prepared, the dimension is very similar as I showed before. When we prepare such a micropillars, then we go to the nano indenter and we deform load in compression, and we are studying the the compression strength, the elastic behavior, the deformation behavior at micro nano level. The last techniques I would like to introduce you for you, the micro cantilever test. Again, we are mapping the system, the microstructure. We select grains, differently orientated grains, or grain boundaries. You see here, the yellow is one grain, the green is one grain. So we preparing from one grains such a micro cantilever. As you can see here, schematically here it is in reality with the dimension, the length is about 10-12 micrometer with such a section. But we can prepare such a cantilevers not only from individual grains, but also from grain boundaries. You see here one grain, second grain, a nice boundary, and we prepared a cantilever from this area or here, one grain, second grain, and grain boundary. And very important that we can select differently orientated grains. So we can prepare, we can study the influence of the differently orientated grains on the grain boundary strength, which is for us very, very important. Of course, not only strength we can measure after when we push here a nano indenter, but we can prepare by focus ion beam also a notch, a sharp notch here somewhere, and we can measure the fracture toughness of individual grains, or if we prepare the notch at the grain boundary, we can study the fracture toughness of the grain boundaries of individual grain boundaries. So I think this is a very nice technique for studying micro nanomechanical properties. Of course, we are using not only fracture mechanics, not only mechanical testing and microstructure characterizations. We are using different fine element modeling, other modelings. We are preparing all models, as for example, the so-called easy sleep model, which was prepared by Tamás Csanády and published here for tungsten carbide grains and applied for other systems. I will mention shortly this model later. Now some results for some systems as regards the micro nano indentation test. I prepared for you a results on zirconium diboride. We got two systems. One is from our friends from London, the second from our friends from United States. And here you see the load displacement curve during the Berkovich indentation of three grains, which have different orientation from the basal. This one is very close to the basal 001 orientation. This is somewhere middle, and this is very close to the prismatic orientation. And you see that the load displacement curves are really different, and also the hardness displacement curves are different for different orientation, and also the indentation modulus curves are different. I can show you the imprints in the material. Here you see one grain, two grain, differently orientated grains and Berkovich indents, and with higher magnification, this is close to the basal basal orientation. Of course, very not easy to find exactly basal orientation. You know, the grains are randomly orientated, but we can find close to the basal this one, middle, between the two orientation, and this is close to the prismatic orientation. So now here you can see how the orientation of the individual grains influence the indentation modulus. Here you can see the indentation modulus. Here it is an angle from basal to prismatic, and angle between the prismatic orientation of the grains and crystal, and you see the indentation modulus is changing quite in the wide range between 6 and 650 GPA for differently orientated grains. Here it is the harness. Here you see the harness, and again important is the phi from basic to prismatic, and here you see how the harness is changing between about 30 and 38 GPA for such a orientation of zirconium diboride grains. So, and this is a two parametric representation. Maybe is better to see, and we have two zirconium diboride systems, the black and the red, and you see here the indentation modulus and the orientation, and how the orientation influences the hardness in this diagram. We got for hardness and indentation modulus for these two differently prepared zirconium diboride grains really quite similar relationships. Here something different, but in main tendency I can say it is really very similar for both zirconium diboride grains. So the indentation modulus is increasing when we going from basal orientation to the prismatic, and as regards the hardness, the highest hardness is at the basal orientation of the grains, the lowest somewhere middle, and here you see a little increase again at prismatic. To see the here we used Berkovich indentation for hardness measurement. To see the plasticity maybe more intensively, we applied also cube corner indentation. Here you see cube corner indentation and around plasticity, very nice plasticity in such a very brittle material as zirconium diboride. And we try to describe how the orientation, the slip system influenced the hardness. In the literature, we found three possible slip systems. Gosh suggested such a slip systems. Haggerty and Lee this slip system, and we found by micropillar compression such a slip system, and we try to apply our easy slip model, which I mentioned was prepared by Tamás and first applied for tungsten carbide. And for tungsten carbide grains, we found a very good agreement between the experimental points in black and the easy slip model red line. So we try to apply the same. Here we use for this model model this sleep system for tungsten carbide grains. We tried to apply the same for zirconium diboride. And when we applied the three mentioned models, we got three lines in green, in red, in blue. And here you see the experimental results. We were surprised why here in this case the experimental results and the prediction is so different. But as I mentioned, when we used cube corner indentation, we found out that here during the indentation, not only one sleep system is working. So there are two or more sleep systems activated in this case. So we try to combine, you know, first these two combination and here these two combination of the sleep systems. And we got the red and blue lines, and these lines are really a very good agreement with the experimental results. So we were satisfied, but which is valid, you know, blue or red is valid. So for this, we try to apply the Schmidt theory, and we found out that if we combine these two sleep systems, there is a prediction according to the Schmidt theory that only one sleep system is working, is green. And we know that there are not more sleep systems, not only one. So we combine these two sleep systems. And in this case, the Schmidt factor theory gives us more deformation possibilities in agreement with our experimental result. So we know which curve is valid for the prediction. So it was a very nice experiment as regards the harness. And now I have 15 minutes. I would like to go through give you some examples for the micro compression and the cantilever test. Also zirconium diboride, we prepared micro pillars perpendicular to the basal, perpendicular to one prismatic orientation grains, and you see the characteristic results. Some micro pillars deform really linearly, no deformation, catastrophic failure, the basal orientation, and some micro pillars are deforming, you know, such a brittle ceramics like zirconium diboride in compression are deforming. So this is the basal, very brittle, going up to about 15 GPA strength, but really very elastic. And the second, the basal orientation, the prismatic orientation you see here is deforming. Here you see sleep deformation in such a very brittle zircon diboride grains. When we studied in detail the orientation, we found out it is a commonly reported orientation, and we found out this orientation, which is the same plane but different direction. And here you see very nice examples for this deformed zircon diboride micropillar. And if we see the engineering stress, engineering strain curves, you see different curves. This is with single sleep system, this one here. And the second is with multi sleep system, you see. This is the sleep, very nice sleep lines, and here the other sleep system. So we published these results in the Journal of the European Ceramic Society. It was at room temperature in a nice collaboration with the group of Professor Mikler from Switzerland. We carried out some high temperature tests at 350 and 500 C for basal and prismatically orientated grains. And you see the results. The in situ was carried out in Switzerland in a microscope at room temperature and 350 and 500, and the ex situ here in Košice. And here you see the results for basal and prismatic grains. So for basal grains, also at higher temperature, there is a linear relationship between the stress strain and the collapsed failure of the micropillars. And in the prismatic orientation, as different, it is different, and you see very stable deformation at 350 and 500 C. It is a larger magnification, and also in situ we were able to record the deformation in the video camera. Sorry, the quality of the pictures are not very nice, but here you see the deformation slip lines. And so zirconium diboride close to the basal orientation, elastic, poof, catastrophic failure. And zirconium diboride grain close to the prismatic orientation, you see at about 3.5 GPA, yield stress, deformation. Very stable deformation takes place, and it is very similar as we found for room temperature test. And when we analyze the damage for such a grains prepared perpendicular to basal orientation, so basal micropillars, you see the room temperature and 350 very similar. And when we prepare the similar for prismatic micropillars, you see very nice slip systems, and very similar for room temperature, 350 C and 500 C. And it was, as I mentioned, also published, I think, 2 years ago. And the last technique or method I would like to introduce you, the microcantilever testing, which is probably closest to the topic of the ACES, you know, fracture mechanics. Fracture mechanics, but not at macro level, but at micro, nano level. So we are very happy to carry out such a test. As I mentioned, we are mapping, it is, for example, tungsten carbide grains in the hard metal, tungsten carbide cobalt hard metal. We select the grains, we are preparing micropillars, and we are testing in bending, you know, with nano indenter. And here you see the load, typical load displacement curve for tungsten carbide grains, which are failing here at the point where is the maximal bending stress, or somewhere here where is not the maximal bending stress, but there is some defect. Similarly as at the macro level. So you see the typical elastic and at the end something plastically deformation area. We will see what's happening here, this one, you know, very elastic, and then something plastic. And when we see the fracture surface of such a samples, you see characteristic fracture surface from up area, you know, the fracture takes place really here, where the bending stress is highest, and you see that before the catastrophic fracture, many times we found slip lines, so deformation in bending, slip lines and some micro cracks from the interaction of slip lines. And such a interaction of slip lines and micro cracks initiated the fracture. But the strength was high and the fracture was initiated not with the defects originally present in the material, but created during the deformation, and this is this part, you know, I believe. The arising such a slip mechanisms as a microcrack. But in some case we found defects, like here you see, and such a defects looks like here. And this defect is very typical and very similar as defect when we studied the bending strength of the hard metals or ceramics in 3 or 4 point bending mode at macro level. And the defects are very small pores for some inclusions. And we see around the defects something like a defect mirror mist Heckel areas, very characteristic for brittle material at fracture at macro level. Sometimes we you see here a higher magnification about the fracture surface of such a materials. As I mentioned, the fracture was orientated after the slip system and crack system arise, and this initiated the fracture of the tungsten carbide grain. You see, this is 1 micron. So this is a micro mechanical test, and the phenomenon we are studying here are at the nano level very often. Sometimes we prepared micro pillars from the boundary between 2 tungsten carbide grains and tungsten carbide cobalt, and here you see the fracture, the load displacement curve and the fracture surface of the boundaries. And it was very interesting to compare the fracture strength of the tungsten carbide grains studied in bending or in tension, or the boundary tungsten carbide studied in bending or tension, and tungsten carbide cobalt boundary. It is very interesting. Still, we are discussing how it is working, that the grain boundaries can influence the strength very, very significantly. This is a twist boundary, low energy twist boundary between the tungsten carbide grains, and this is a high energy boundary, and you see the strengths are different. The second material I would like to show, but as I mentioned, afternoon Tamás Csanády will speak maybe more about the system, high entropy ceramics, high entropy carbides. Such a materials were developed only 2 or published only 2 years ago. All grains have the same chemical composition. We prepared cantilevers from these grains, you see. Such a cantilever looks like here. And we tested the strength of the cantilevers and what we found. When the fracture is here, without defect, you see the stress is up to 12 GPa, and you see the fracture surface. We can find the fracture origins, you see here, but no defects, nothing. Probably the fracture origin is a surface defect, probably is caused by the focus ion beam preparation. We are working on this. But you see the fracture origin the fracture defect origin is very small, and probably it is surface defect. Sometimes we found defect inside, and you see very nice fracture origins, not at the point where the tensile stress are the highest, but here somewhere. But you see they are in the form of pores or secondary phase. We prepare the information Weibull plot. Of course, you know the Weibull plot for ceramics is usually for with 30 measured strength values, but of course we had not too many specimens. But here you see the information Weibull plot with the points. The blue points means the fracture origins were defects, like here, and the red points are where we see fracture origins, but they are probably surface defects after the fib preparation. And you see different strength values, and here using Weibull modulus 22 approximately, and here you see Weibull modulus significantly lower. So to eliminate such a small defects, it is very important, because we can improve not only the strength but also the Weibull modulus. And the last examples and the last 1-2 minutes in my lecture, we studied also silicon nitride ceramics. You know, the very, very well-known system, silicon nitride system. And we studied a small grain size system that in the cantilever we had many, many grains with different grain boundaries, chemically different grain boundaries. And we studied also strength of individual silicon nitride grains. And the results, here you see singular grains. Again, the strengths go up to about 8-10 GPa. We found some fracture origins. This is a very nice, very typical fracture origin you see here, with characteristic defect mirror mist Haeckel regions. And we compared the strength and the cross-section area for alpha silicon nitride whiskers from the literature. Iwanaka published this with very high strengths, you see, about from 22 to 60 GPi strengths. We found lower strengths for beta silicon nitride, about 12, as I mentioned, and without defects, and here with defects, the green points, about 6 GPa. And it's very interesting to study the polycrystalline silicon nitride with different grain boundaries. Here you see a fracture of a cantilever with such a polycrystalline material. And here you see the fracture surface. You see, it's very nice to study where the fracture propagates. If propagates intergranularly, then the grain boundary can have a very significant influence. And we are carrying out such a study recently, and we are waiting for the equipment through which we will be able to do in situ tests up to 800 C, and we will follow in this study in the future. So the summary, I offer you a very short overview concerning the micro nanomechanical testing of brittle ceramics, harness, micro pillar, micro cantilever, what is happening at our institute and over the world in this field. And we believe that such a test open new possibilities for us in designing materials, structures with suitable oriented grains with enhanced hardness, wear resistance, polycrystalline ceramics with tailored grain size distribution and grain orientation with potentially enhanced room temperature ductility, and to design hardier ductile ceramics in the future that are wear and high temperature resistant for a variety of micro and nanomechanical applications. So thank you very much for your attention, and best wishes from Košice, which is our city with this nice cathedral in the background. Thank you very much for your attention.